Yeah, Wednesday. I'm Coach Skip at Wildfire CrossFit, and I have your workout for today. We're going to start with a warm-up. 3 rounds, 200-meter run, or go a minute out and back again, so about 30 seconds out and then back again, or do about a minute of running in place. If you're running in place, really get those arms and legs moving together. Make sure you get that heart rate up, your lungs burning. We want you to get moving here in this first 200. Then we're going to get into 10 side lunges. So take that big step to the side, really open up those hips, and 5 each side on those side lunges. If you need to hold on to something for balance, if that'll help you get lower into that lunge, go for it. Whatever's going to help you open up those hips. Then we're going to go into 10 plank to push-ups. So you're going to start on those forearms and then just go all the way up to that push-up position and back down. And then either switch each arm, which arm goes up first each time, or do 5 on one side and then do 5 on the other, where you're going up on the other side. Then we're going to do 20 flutter kicks. Right plus left equals 1 on these. Keep that hollow position, lower back's on the ground, point those toes, get that good kick, right plus left is 1. If you need to, you can put your hands underneath your butt to stabilize those hips a little bit more. Then at the end of the round, you're going to take 1 minute to stretch. So whatever sore, you can do this lunge and twist stretch. You can just get down here in this lunge and get things opened up. You can go bottom of the squat. You could do a sitting couch stretch where you grab onto that ankle and pull up and really stretch out that quad. Thread the needles back and forth. You could even do a child's pose using a box or a bench or the rig. Whatever you need to do to get things opened up for the workout. Then, for the strength today, after you do 3 rounds of the warm-up, we're going to get into the shoulder press. So on that shoulder press, this is a strict movement. If you've got a rack, you can go off of a rack. If you don't, it's okay, because this is already going to be a lighter weight exercise, because when we get in here, we're keeping that core tight, butt squeezed, knees locked, and just strict press overhead. Get that head through the window. Bring that bar all the way back down to the shoulders each time. Now, a couple weeks ago, we did a 1 rep max shoulder press, and so this is building on that, because we've got percentages. So the whole goal is to stick with these percentages of your 1 rep max. So get a warm-up set or 2, and then get into these percentages. 5 reps at 60% of your 1 rep max, then at 65, 75, and 85%. And really just make sure that entire time you're keeping locked out, getting that press. And remember, when you squeeze your butt, you're not going to be able to bend your knees. And so you can't bend your knees when your butt is squeezed. So really squeeze your butt the entire time, and that'll help. If you don't have a barbell, you can always do this with dumbbells. And same thing, get into that same position, tight core, rack position, press right overhead, right back down again. So that is the strength for today. For the workout, we've got a CrossFit Classic in Nicole. This is a 20-minute AMRAP. So yes, you're doing as many rounds as possible, and each round is going to start with a 400-meter run. So you can do a 400-meter run, or do a 2-minute run in place, or run a minute out and then back again, or just 2 minutes of cardio. Running in place, some jump rope, rowing, biking, whatever you've got that's going to keep those lungs burning, that's what we're looking for 2 minutes in a row minimum. Then, once you come in from that run, or once you get done with that cardio, you're going to do as many pull-ups as you can do unbroken. Now, on these pull-ups, you can go kipping, butterfly, whatever you need to do to be able to get that chin over the bar every time. And just that kipping motion is going to be a really good solution to be able to get your energy and your hip energy going to help you get over the bar. But this is unbroken. So once you come off the bar, whether you do 2 reps or 20 reps, then you're going to take off on that run again. And the whole point is to get as many pull-ups as possible in that 20 minutes of time, knowing that each round is going to start with that 400-meter run or 2 minutes of cardio. If you need to modify, you can do a jumping pull-up where you've got that object, you're bending at the knees and jumping and pulling over the bar. Just when you're doing the jumping pull-up, make sure, A, you're challenging yourself and really getting that full range of motion, full lockout at the bottom, chin all the way up over the bar, but stick to a number, 10, 15, maybe even 20 reps there at a time. But stick to that number, because with jumping pull-ups, a lot of times you can keep going. You could also do a banded pull-up. Same thing. Use that kipping motion, and that's going to be a little bit more challenging to hit those numbers and fatigue so that you're actually getting a max rep without just spending 20 minutes hanging on the bar. If you don't have a bar to be able to do your pull-ups, you can also do a bent-over row. That bent-over row, if you're using a barbell, you're going to be right here in this good morning position where you're bringing that bar right up to your chest and all the way back down, right up and down here. A good suggested weight for the bent over row to still make it challenging would be about half your body weight. You can do this with dumbbells, same thing, where you get into that position and just right up and down. And when all else fails, if you don't have any of that, you can always turn this up into a push-up workout where you're doing as many push-ups as possible when you come in from that run or that cardio and build that up as well. So get a lot of pull-ups. That's what we're doing. We want to build up that chest, shoulder, or upper body strength. Have fun on that run. Really get those lungs burning. But make sure when you get back in, you're ready to go. So slow it down as you start to come back in. Shake out those arms and legs so that you're ready to go on that pull-up bar as soon as you come back in. So thanks, guys. Have fun. Have a good one. Hit it hard, and we will see you soon.